Hello guys! Not long ago, Parkside launched this quick release nut for angle grinders, and I finally managed to get my hands on it. So let's take a closer look. The price is different in the different countries, but in average it's about 10 euros. The idea here is the user to be able with minimal force to firmly secure the cutting disc, and again with minimal force to be able to untighten the nut when needed, and all this without using the strange looking and clumsy spanner that comes with your angle grinder. It wasn't hard at all to disassemble the nut. There were two circlips holding all parts together. Now let me show you the internals. First we have this grey disc with rough surface that is pressing onto the cutting disc. Beneath it we have a spacer just above the roller bearing. We have a rubber O-ring, most likely to protect the roller bearing from dust and debris. And of course, we have the roller bearing itself. Next, under the second circlip, which I already removed, we have a metal plate. That is protecting the remaining parts of the mechanism. Here you can see the three springs. Let's remove them. Following is this little grooved disc. You can see the grooves on it. 8 grooves. And beneath it, we have 8 little rollers, those shiny little things. Let me remove the collet, we don't need it anymore. Here we have a limiter, this disc. It's limiting the rotation of the rollers and the disc retaining them. Let me remove the disc with the rollers. And lastly is this disc nut, let's call it a disc nut. This is the part that goes onto the spindle of your angle grinder. I've reassembled some of the parts in order to show you where the magic happens. In normal conditions, which are achieved by the pre-award springs, or when tightening the nut, the 8 rollers are outside of their grooves. Due to that, the whole nut assembly is a little bit thicker, a fraction of a millimeter. When the user tries to unscrew the nut assembly, the 8 rollers go inside of their grooves and the nut assembly becomes a fraction of the millimeter thinner. In result, it's much easier to overcome the friction in the thread of the spindle and the friction between this disc and the cutting disc. Let me show it to you more visually. Pay attention. This is the thickness of the nut assembly when in normal conditions or when you're trying to tighten it up. And this is the thickness when you're trying to untighten it. Again, when you're trying to tighten it up. And when you're trying to unscrew it. Here you can see it even better. Pay attention to this pin over here. This is the condition of the nut when you try to tighten it up. And this is the condition when you try to untighten it. Again, when you try to tighten it. And when you try to unscrew it. You can see this difference in thickness of about a fraction of a millimeter. The purpose of the three springs is to keep the 8 rollers out of their grooves and to allow you to put them inside when you apply a little bit of force. In conclusion, I might say it's really clever and quite useful little gadget with reasonable price, and I could only suggest you to buy one. That's all from me. If you'd like the video, you know what to do.